A reading from the Gospel of Luke, the 8th chapter. They came to land in the country of the Gerasenes, which is opposite Galilee. Jesus was stepping ashore when a man from the town who was possessed by devils came towards him. For a long time the man had worn no clothes, nor did he live in a house, but in the tombs. Catching sight of Jesus, he gave a shout, fell at his feet, and cried out at the top of his voice, "What do you want with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God? I implore you, do not torture me." For Jesus had been telling the unclean spirit to come out of the man. It was a devil that had seized on him a great many times, and then they used to secure him with chains and fetters to restrain him. But he would always break the fastenings, and the devil would drive him out into the wilds. "What is your name?" Jesus asked. "Legion," he said, because many devils had gone into him. And these pleaded with him not to order them to depart into the abyss. Now there was a large herd of pigs feeding there on the mountain, and the devils pleaded with him to let them go into these. So he gave them leave. The devils came out of the man and went into the pigs, and the herd charged down the cliff into the lake and were drowned. When the swineherd saw what had happened, they ran off and told their story in the town and in the country round about, and the people went out to see what had happened. When they came to Jesus, they found the man from whom the devils had gone out sitting at the feet of Jesus, clothed and in his full senses, and they were afraid. Those who had witnessed it told them how the man who had been possessed came to be healed. The entire population of the Gerasene territory was in a state of panic and asked Jesus to leave them. So he got into the boat and went back.
Jesus drives the demons out of a possessed man. His very words were enough to set the man free from bondage. We are not likely ever to be an exorcist, but we all have the power to pray over someone who appears to need deliverance. A group of people praying in the Spirit can break the bonds of possession. In some ways, we all need deliverance.
How do you deal with people who are suffering from mental illness?
Well, I was a chaplain in a mental hospital in Edmonton, and dealt with hundreds of these really very ill people. I always spoke to them as if they were totally normal. I didn't make any reference to the fact that maybe they were hearing me in a totally different way. And then I would invite them to respond. Some of them were able to, you know, have a fairly decent conversation, having listened to what I said. Others would really, really struggle, and I could tell that the message had not really been able to penetrate. But then, before I left them, I always put my hand on their head and gave them a special blessing, leaving them the Spirit of God with them. Even though I was leaving, God's Spirit would be with them. And many of them used to weep when I would bless them.
Really?
Yes. Which is very, men as well as women. I'd put my hand on their head and they'd start weeping.
When Jesus saw this man,
yes,
that's pretty much the response he had.
Yeah, exactly.
Because he could, that love, I mean, he was consumed.
Yes.
This is a little more difficult.
Yeah.
Demons.
Demons are, you know, in people, not by the will of God, but by the evil one, who takes possession. And it takes a specific exorcistic prayer in order to drive them out. And like when he came to the Jezerene territory and saw this man who was able to break out of chains and was cutting himself all the time and so on and so forth, that all portrayed the depth of his possession, because he was not doing this to himself, it was being done to him. And it took Jesus' special words of deliverance to send those pigs, or those demons, into the pigs, who then went down the bank into the sea and were drowned, you know. And the people were not very happy with Jesus for doing that. And they wanted, and they said, get out of our country. We don't want you here, because of what he had done with the pigs. They didn't really refer to the fact that gloriously this man was delivered.
Do you have to want to be delivered?
Yes. You play a role in it, but the role of grace is greater than the desire of the individual. So if I say deep within myself, please deliver me, please deliver me, and God's grace pours in and the words are spoken, then it happens. But I do have to play my role in it. And in the hospital, I'm not an exorcist, but I used to pray over all people, whether they were Jewish or Catholic or Protestant, it didn't matter. I went the rounds. And, you know, for many of them, all I was able to do was come and stand beside their bed and maybe put my hand on their shoulder and I say, may I say a prayer for you? Mm. I never was refused.
Never.
Yeah. Didn't matter who they were, I'd say a little prayer of healing. Yeah.
It seems that if someone lets the evil in, the evil one, and what I think about is some of these horrendous things during war that happen, that a normal human being would not be doing that. But it's like they're possessed by evil.
They're taken over, yes.
And to get rid of that, it takes, I think, a special healing to be able to exercise that from your psyche, from your spirit. And I just see it as the enemy.
Well, he's very active. And if he once gets inside you, then he just works on you and it becomes worse and worse. And that's when you call in a real exorcist who has been trained and, you know, may take a whole week or 2 weeks praying over them constantly or as much as you can before any movement.
Have you seen that?
No, I have never been present at an exorcism, but I've read many books about it where they describe where the priest tells you how even he felt, how he was attacked because he was doing this good thing.
But you sure can be, you can sure be in the presence of evil and just feel like it just puts shivers down you.
Somebody's really possessed by it. Exactly, you know.
As we think about this poor man, the Gerasene demoniac, whom Jesus healed and set free and restored to a place of peace and tranquility so that he was in his right mind. We pray also for all those that we know of who are suffering from some kind of mental or emotional distress. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, have mercy on all your children who live in mental distress. Restore them to strength of mind and cheerfulness of spirit, and give them health and peace. Almighty and everlasting God, comfort of the sad and strength to those who suffer, Let the prayers of your children who are in any trouble rise to you. To everyone in distress, grant mercy. Grant relief. Grant refreshment. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.